Hello out there in YouTube land. Well, it's time for another video on the engine leveler. In this episode, we're going to finish welding up the trolley. We're going to get the lead screw mounts made and installed. And we're going to, we're just going to get as far along as we can. So let's get this show going. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take this over and grind a weld relief in these two edges and a couple on these edges. And then we'll come back and we'll get this baby welded. Hey. Got a weld relief ground in there, so okay, now get this baby welded up. All right. Get this off of the frame now. We'll clean that frame back up. Okay, let's get this cleaned up and then we'll finish welding that crate. That's all cleaned back up now, so let's go ahead and set it back over on the bench here and get ready to finish welding that crate. Well, I'm going to take this bottom slide off, and we need to go over and get it ground and get it polished up. Thank you. Okay. Man, that's looking pretty nice. Let's take this over to the sander and hit these edges and get it ready to go. This slide plate. Take her over now. Take it back over to the sander, see if we can't get her polished up a little bit more. It's hot though. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and polish on this a little more. I believe a surface grinder is going to be in my future. Man, would that be handy right now. Slide plate done, so we'll have to be putting that on very shortly. Right now, I need to put these bolts back in here, get this put back in. We have the carriage here all put together. So what we're going to need to do next is cut us a couple chunks out of here and make us the lead screw mounts. But first, I need to get this up against and we get a measurement from here to the bed. Okay, let's see what we've got here. Got 447 thousandths. We're going to use 450 plus half, 682. We will need half of that 682. So we're going to need our blocks at 1¼ by 1.415. Okay, let's go ahead and get those started.
Beautiful.
Let's get this hole in here. This will be here. One more half inch hole. Actually, let me check that dimension. Okay, well, let's get our edge set. Find the center and the edge. Okay. Center width 0.79, and we'll board this 31/64. This bad, we're gonna sharpen that. Oh yeah, well, that's sharp. Okay, let's try that out now and see how it does. Yeah, it looks nice. Yeah, okay. We'll try this bit now. See how she does. Okay, there we go. Turn the three-phase on. And now let's drill this. Oh, that's a little better. That's better. We have the holes drilled now. Let's take them over and countersink it. Put a filler on there. Okay. Thank you.
truly does a nice job sizing them holes when you want a little precision. Like I said, this is the mount for the lead screw, and we want a precise hole for that lead screw. That is why that you're going to the time and the effort to bore this hole instead of just drilling it with a half-inch drill and it being the size of 15,000 loose. This is the way we do it in a couple of times.
That got them done. They're bored now. We'll go over to the bench and chamfer those edges.
So, man, they look nice. Okay.
We've got the lead screw mounts bored now. We'll go ahead and get those countersunk. Too fast. Those look real nice. That. Perfect. I mean, those are nice, very nice. Radius up here on the top. So let me go get something to lay that out, and we'll get a little radius on there. Okay, let's go over to the sander and get this thing rounded off. I'm going to get started here mopping up the lead screw and getting the mounts welded in place. get some cushion on it with. Okay, now we're shim 30. We're dead nuts in the center, okay? Let's make sure that we're in the center with this and in the center at both ends. And then we'll lock this in place. Eight. Three quarters. Okay. That's set. Yeah. Let's tack this one in. That welded up. Let's go ahead and set it back up on the bench, and we'll get the other end spotted in. Well, let's try the pliers. See if we can get that shimmed up. I need needle noses. Alrighty. No problem. None at on each side, so that's got that. And that's in the middle, and that can't go nowhere. So, she's all spotted in. Let's get her pulled apart and finish welding things up. get this carriage off, and then we'll get everything fine and welded. Put our shim down here. Should be all we need the shims for. We're going to weld this stuff up here in a second. Go ahead and pull this carriage off. So it doesn't warp when we do the welding up here at the top. Okay, here's this part, and here's the frame. Go ahead and put the frame in there first, get it finished welded in, cleaned all back up, and then we'll concentrate on the crate. Got the frame all welded. So let's get the trolley across over here and we'll weld it up. Then we get everything cleaned back up. Got her ground all up and reassembled. I did that offline. It's really turning out nice. I mean, the motion is just absolutely smooth. Those bearings in here really, really improved that motion. I mean, it's very smooth, very smooth, very easy to turn. Had to retap the center coupling there when I welded it up. It kind of distorted the thread, so I did have to do a retap there. But I believe we're at a good ending point, so we're going to go ahead and end the video here. I will, next time, we have the handle to make. And we have the pulling strap to actually put on the carriage here. And then, well, I think that's got it. Then we'll have the powder coat to do. And that'll have it whipped. So, guys, subscribe. I sure would appreciate it. Like, share, click that notification bell so you know when I put out new videos. And until next time, have a real good one.